180 side by side, boom. Look at that, we already get a live feed. See, it's very fast. So we got real-time live feed in 3D VR 180 straight out from the camera feed to Vision Pro. And this is by far the best on-set monitoring. Kimchi behind me right there. I can actually see him. Kimchi behind me, this is way better. Like, Kimchi's right there, like walking around. Right now, we actually have a very reliable on-set live preview solution. On any camera, not just the Canon R5C, right? This can be the brand new Blackmagic URSA Cine Immersive. It's crazy. My mouth is synced like perfectly, no delay. We never get this kind of like crazy smooth live feed ever. Thanks to the Hollyland Cosmo C2 and my workflow. Now everything works beautifully.
What about Meta Quest? Look like Hugh also figured out how to get it to work on Meta Quest 3.
You damn right, Kimchi. This wireless setup VR live preview workflow will work on both Meta Quest and Apple Vision Pro with almost no latency. Let's learn now. Hey, what's up everybody? It's your boy Hugh here, the crazy immersive filmmaker and tech wizard, back with another episode of the immersive camera workflow tutorial. And this one, it's a big one. We're talking about real-time wireless on-set preview with zero noticeable latency, a minimal setup, and a rock solid reliability. Now, if you haven't already, I highly recommend checking out our previous tutorial right here on how to preview your camera feed with the Meta Quest 3. It is super in-depth and lay out the groundwork for what we are doing here. But that setup was wired. It required an HDMI or SDI cable from the camera to your PC, which, let's be honest, isn't ideal for a clean, flexible workflow. Plus, we left out Apple Vision Pro, which turned out deliver even better image quality and more stable performance than the Quest 3. Clients are usually blown away when they see the live 3D 180 feed through the Vision Pro on set. It gives them a crystal clear preview of what the camera captured right then and there.
There you go.
So, how do we make all this possible? We need a professional-grade wireless transmitter and receiver that supports NDI. And guess what? Hollyland just released one. The moment it's launched, I grabbed it because we knew this was missing puzzle piece to tie the entire workflow together. Let me walk you through the full setup step by step so you can do it too. Okay, let's talk about the Frankenstein setup right here. As you see, here's OBS in doing actually a live stream. Well, we're not really live stream, it's like camera to headset. And here is the cameras, right here. And then this actually got streamed into Meta Quest. So we will get live in the Meta Quest, in OBS, in camera monitor. This is the Canon right here. That's the Canon through the network and into my Vision Pro. So first, let's start from camera run. We have just a regular Sony, it's a regular doing a regular live stream through the Hollyland Cosmo C2 HDMI wirelessly going into the receiver. Receiver number one, by the way, this is wireless connection. And then with the camera number two right here with the Canon R5C, this is the main camera, right? This is the VR camera going to the Cosmo C2 second sender right there. Wirelessly again, send it to the control center right here, the Cosmo receiver. And then this have two HDMI output, right? One is from the VR feed, which is going into my small rig right here. And sorry, not my small rig, it's small HD, 4K monitor, very expensive small HD 4K monitor. And then the second camera feed, just a 2D feed, we're going to our Shogun 2 right here. So we got two camera feed. And then all of this goes through Ethernet, through NDI, going into my laptop right here, just connect to, if you see the back of it, it's connect to the Ethernet cable right here, and then just going in here and in the OBS, just pick up NDI signal right here, and then using tutorial, I will show you right my old tutorial basically, we do a live stitch through OBS, send NDI out, and from the NDI, I send it to my Apple Vision Pro right here, and then also NDI out to Meta Quest, so we get a live feed to see everything. So see this entire setup, let me just get you the wide shot right here. Here, OBS, right here. And then we have two camera feed, we can have three or four, whatever camera feed we have, and then going through one command center right there. This is the Hollyland Cosmo C2 receiver, and sending out two HDMI, doing a video village live preview for the client. But at the same time, we're streaming this thing out on the internet, or just locally, through as many headsets we can connect to, and then everybody can see it in VR in 3D. This is the setup. Before we dive into the workflow, let's quickly talk about this seriously underrated piece of gear, the Hollyland Cosmo C2 HDMI and SDI wireless video transmitter system. Now, let's be clear, this isn't a sponsored video or a full review. I just want to share my professional thought on this dual transmitter system because it solved a lot of headaches in immersive production. So, why the Cosmo C2 right here? Two big reasons. First, minimal latency. The Cosmo C2 now delivers super low latency, less than 33 milliseconds. That's a massive improvement over Hollyland's previous products. It's still not as fast as Teradex, but honestly, it's so close, you have a hard time noticing. You can even pull focus with it, which says a lot. Second, seamless frequency hopping. This is crucial for live broadcasts, especially in crowded environment like sport arena or concert, where everyone has their phone out. Seamless frequency hopping help avoid interference, ensure a stable signal. Now, full transparency, I haven't tested the Cosmo C2 on a live production just yet, but I will soon. So if you want to see how it holds up in the field, subscribe here on YouTube and follow me on Instagram. I'll be sharing live on set update and a more detailed review soon. Here is why this thing is so exciting for immersive production. It has crazy range, like up to 1,000 meters and around 3,000 feet. It's a huge for 360 production, where the entire crew need to stay out of the shot. It also has dual camera sync, which means it can wirelessly connect two cameras and send both signal back to the signal receiver right here, just one receiver. So if you are running a custom dual camera rig for 3D production, you get both feet side by side that make it way easier to spot issues like color drifting or focus mismatching. And it has built-in NDI support. And that's exactly what we need for immersive live streaming. Now, to be clear, you don't have to use Hollyland Cosmo C2 to get live preview in your headset. Any wireless transmitter with similar spec will work, but the Cosmo C2 is definitely the most affordable in its class, and it comes with a ton of quality of live feature that make it harder to beat. If you already have a Teradex system, use it. If you want a more budget-friendly option, you can even go with the Magewell wire solution. All right, now let's get into the actual workflow and set up your Dual Fisheye camera feed for live preview in the Meta Quest 3 or Apple Vision Pro. The Cosmo C2 receiver can actually act like a video capture card, giving you live video feed from two cameras at once. To get that video signal, just hold down the middle button to open the menu, scroll to streaming and check UVC. Once that's enabled, grab a USB-C cable and connect the Cosmo C2 receiver directly to your PC. Open up OBS and you will see the video feed pop up like this. There should be two UVC feed, one for each camera if you are using a dual camera setup. But if you are using a Canon Dual Fisheye lens like I do, you only need one of these feed, which makes things way simpler. Now, NDI is what we use to send the raw fisheye feed straight to the headset, but there is currently no way to stitch the video live inside the headset itself. So we have to handle the stitching on the PC first and then send the processed NDI signal back to the headset. We have got an even simpler solution coming soon that will cut the PC out of the equation entirely. So don't forget to follow us on Instagram. But for now, we will still need to follow this tutorial. Here's the workflow. First, record a 1080p video feed from the Hollyland to LBS, then open DaVinci Resolve to generate a STMap. Next, take the STMap and fit it into my custom OBS setup to stitch the footage into a proper VR.NDI side-by-side format. After that, you can broadcast the NDI streaming directly to your headset of choice, whether it's Meta Quest 3 or Apple Vision Pro. And to make things easier, I will provide my STMap and JSON file as a free download of this video. If you are not chasing the perfect 3D alignment, you can use this file as is. But if you need more precision, you can easily tweak them in DaVinci Resolve to fit your exact setup. Okay, let's move on to the next step to to get that live video feed into your headset. Okay, so final step, like we are in central control right here. We're streaming through NDI from my PC right here all the way into the headset. I'm looking myself live. Camera's right here. You see like no delay. But this is not VR yet. It's just left and right. It's 180 left and right. So how can I turn to VR? In MetaQuest, it's actually very easy. I'm using a MetaQuest browser right here. You just need to make sure that you're in full screen mode. Double click onto it. Yeah, right here. Hit this full screen mode. Now, boom, you can pick it. So now you just make sure that pick VR 180 left and right, which is this is what the Canon capture, right? Boom. Boom, look at that. Okay. Now we see a live no delay feed. Look at that. 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3. Literally no delay. And it's playing at 60 frames per second, 1080p. I mean, 1080p is okay, good enough for kind of see what is going on. Again, they gotta spend most of the time on the actual Hollyland feed into the video village. They don't want to wear a headset on set. Client usually want to be socialized, so they don't want to be in here. But they do want to check out the stereo, make sure that the talent's good. It's gonna look great. And then when you have that, you can strap a headset on them for like maybe 5 minutes, 10 minutes, whatever, however long they want to be in the headset, right? Again, this is only one headset right here, but we can actually stream to like 10, 100 headset live, because it's just through Ethernet right here. Depending on your internet bandwidth, it just gets streamed straight into the headset. This is by far the fastest way, easiest way, but also a no delay way to really get a live feed from camera, VR camera to headset through Hollyland wirelessly, OBS, my workflow, wirelessly using NDI into the headset. There you go. Now, if you are not a fan of using central control with the MetaQuest browser, there's another option. Our good friend over at Lightcell recently released a new plugin called V-Raptor Untethered. It's not a free app. It costs around $25 on the MetaQuest store. But as you can see here, the interface is way more straightforward compared to the free MetaQuest browser. It instantly detects my NDI feed coming from OBS, and the setup is super simple. Now, you will still need my free OBS workflow to sit your raw fisheye footage into VR-180 before broadcasting the NDI feed, but you can skip the central control entirely, which actually saves you more money in the long run. And as you can see, both setups are pretty fast. The delay from the live camera feed to the MetaQuest headset is minimum, making it totally usable for on-set monitoring. That said, if you want my favorite and completely free workflow to preview your camera feed live in a headset, then you want to use Apple Vision Pro. Let me show you how that works now. So now we are doing our Vision Pro right here. As you see, the MetaQuest is just putting right there. Vision Pro, fortunately, is a lot easier. So again, same concept, right? Camera, the VR camera, which is the Canon R5C, just drop the battery. The Canon R5C right here. Again, going to the Hollyland Cosmo C2 into the receiver right here. The receiver gonna go into NDI to my computer right here. We stitch live stitch right here, pipe NDI out. So NDI is now coming out straight from my PC right here. So Vision Pro is super easy. Like, I will show you. Like, go me here, go to Visio right here. This is a free app. You can download for free. Just open that. And then see, you already see my OBS Hollyland live right here. So just hit it. And then go Immersive. We can get 180 side by side. Boom. Look at that. We already get a live feed. See, it's very fast. It's real time. Vision Pro is even faster. Vision Pro have really good NDI probably built inside of Vision Pro because it's expensive, so we have everything. So we got real time live feed in 3D VR 180 straight out from the camera feed to Vision Pro. And this is by far the best on-set monitoring I ever come up with, because the camera, Kimchi behind me right there, I can actually see him. Kimchi behind me, this is way better. Like, Kimchi's right there, like walking around. But anyway, this is very meta, so right now we actually have a very reliable on-set live preview solution. On any camera, not just the Canon R5C, right? This can be the brand new Blackmagic URSA Cine Immersive. It can be the Red V-Raptor. It can be any VR camera that can pipe out a 1080p 60 frames per second feed into wirelessly in the Hollyland, Hollyland's Cosmo C2, which handles the logic for you, going to the PC. We can design a template, which will provide all the templates for free, by the way. You can download it on my Patreon and download them. And then just if I don't have a camera, like template that for you, just DM me, comment below, and I will make a template for you if you give me a video file. So we live stitch from OBS and OBS NDI into the same network and then go straight wirelessly on my Vision Pro. And then I see a live feed right here, right now. It's crazy. My mouse is synced like perfectly, no delay. We never get this kind of like crazy smooth live feed ever. Thanks to the Hollyland Cosmo C2 and my workflow, now everything works beautifully. So the only real downside of this workflow is that the live stream inside the headset is currently limited to 1080p at 60 frames per second. For most production, that's more than enough for a solid 3D preview. But if you saw my previous tutorial right here, you know we achieved 4K 60 frames per second, but that required a lot more gear on set and it wasn't wireless. Now you have got both options, the simpler wireless workflow we covered today and a higher resolution wired solution from before. This wireless workflow works straight out of the box with the new Blackmagic URSA Cine Immersive camera. Blackmagic has already promised an even better native resolution workflow with 4K 90 frames per second live preview inside Apple Vision Pro. And as soon as that drops, I will make a follow-up tutorial to walk you through the entire process step by step. So if you are as excited about the future of immersive filmmaking as I am, don't forget to subscribe and hit that bell icon. Seriously, Kimchi needs your support. He has been working overtime to help me create content like this one for the community. And hey, if you want to see this technology in action, check out our latest 16K 90 frames per second immersive film shot in France right here. Thank you for watching, and I will see you in the next tutorial. Ciao!